What is the omega point? One may speculate by defining it as absolute consciousness, the source of the omnidimensional matrix, that is the holographic projector of all possible observer timelines, including other permutational modalities such as possible anti-timelines in our quantum multiverse, as well as possible modalities in even larger inflationary multiverse, all pasts, presents and futures, and other yet inconceivable to us pattern crawlings exist as potentiality until experienced. In brief, it is the source of everything. In my life as a human, I see clues that evolution on Earth and elsewhere in the cosmos at large is not being pushed from behind in entropic randomness but being pulled forward by complexification, natural selection and other evolutionary forces orchestrated by a strange unseen teleological attractor, in McKenna's words, the transcendental object at the end of time. The Noosphere is the collective consciousness of humanity. The networks of thought and emotion in which we all are immersed, it's a cognitive layer of the planet, which has found a physical expression in the form of today's internet. As the Noosphere gains more coherence, typical of a biological brain, this process of planet cognification accelerates. Eventually, the Noosphere gains total dominance over the biosphere and reaches a point of complete independence from tangential energy, that is material substrata, forming a metaphysical being, Teilhard calls the omega point. One may see significant overlapping ideas between the transhumanist technological singularity and the Teilhardian omega point. Excerpt from The Origins of Us, Evolutionary Emergence and the Omega Point Cosmology by Alex Vikilov, available now as ebook on Amazon.
Extadelic Media.